Testing, 1, 2, 3, testing. Okay, that's good. Something different than just plain old Octavia, so I picked up Fiddlesticks here. I like the art style, so I figured, what the hell, let's see what I can do with it. That, and I've been spoiled with Octavia pictures, only because she comes pretty grayscaled. It's really interesting to see how colors mix when there are actually colors there. Ooh. Yeah, she's actually been in two episodes. She was in the Nightmare Night episode as well as the Apple Family reunion. I thought she was just Octavia in a costume. She was actually finally defined as an actual other character was because they had her in that episode. I'm not going to be doing any, you know, actual editing of the image. I'm just going to be recoloring it to Soryu's colors. But as you could see earlier on, you know, because of the different hues that they use for this character, I can't just use the same exact same pattern. Usually I just multiply in the fur color and then do another layer with it overlaid. But if I just do that, you know, it just brightens up the yellow. It doesn't bring out any of the actual color I used. So I gotta grayscale it as well. perfect for controlled grayscales. Let's make a new layer. And this is a trick that I learned recently for selecting. If you control click the layer, you select wherever it's been colored. And it doesn't select any of the transparency on that particular layer. Now, on the new layer I created, fill in with white. And then set that layer to color, or hue. And bam, wherever it's white is now gray. So that when I put on the color I colored over, it now goes along with as it's supposed to be. Set the overlay as it was supposed to be. There you go. That's one way to do it. I could probably finagle the blending without the white to get like this as it's supposed to be, but you know, I just prefer doing it the way I normally do it, simply so that it's, you know, something I'm used to. But looks like, you know, even just set this to hue instead of multiply works pretty well. Like I said, I prefer to have it blended the way I normally do it so I can keep better control. Yeah, the thing with vinyl, though, is that she becomes pretty white, and that's a pain in the ass to, you know, blend sometimes. Especially if they don't have really good contrast with the shadows. Now let's see how well the hair goes. Get rid of some of the purple in it. So I'll probably still do the same thing. By the way, if you notice, this is at the 100% zoom right here. Yeah, I'm not even zoomed in on this thing. I normally go 500, but I think that's a bit big. My brush is a size 50. you'll notice I'm getting pretty sloppy here with the coloring and things like that. It has to do with simply this image and the art style. It's very painterly, it's very sketchy on its own. So the fact that colors are bleeding over don't matter too much. sure, easy enough to recolor. Just chose the yellow one, yellow color, and set it to hue. Now I could like set it to color and give it a bit of more of a blandish eh. Who seem to work pretty well. Maybe if I do that, set it to overlay. Actually, I was thinking that was part of her back. Shirt's hiked up, pants pulled down a little bit.
Yeah.
sticking with that. Trying to get it to look a bit more similar to how they have it in the painting. much all I was planning on doing with this one. Well, good day, Ocean.